You know what is going to cost you a lot of money? That curved shit. Those curved TVs.
Those are even worse. I don't get them.
I understand them to a point. The really, really large TVs in the living room, they don't really have the best viewing angle. No. And so if you're off to the side on those TVs, it kind of sucks. So what you do is you curve them, and then the viewing angle suddenly doesn't matter because you could see everything because the viewing angle is
Yeah, but we're talking like 60-inch plus.
Yeah, that is the only use case is like the 50-inch plus category. Everything else, like there was at CES, there was like a 30-inch curved TV. And I'm like, why the fuck are you doing this? That's just stupid.
How? No. My question is, how close do you think I will sit to this?
Well, like a year away, I guess.
Do you want me to lick the screen?
Yes, I want you to lick the screen.
So if you're making a 30-inch curved TV,
I want you to be inside the screen itself.
Probably.
I want you.
You can.
I want you to be inside the screen. I want you to be a pixel, Darish, all right? Be a pixel.
That is a big
inside
TV.
The screen.
You have a 4K TV where a pixel is as big as Darish, that is a big TV.
That's a big TV. Really big TV.
That need to be curved.
Yes, I think it will.
How far away would you need to be to see a TV with pixels the size of Darish?
I know there's math to figure this out.
That's kidding. That's a lot of math, isn't it?
I know how to solve this. I'm not gonna, but I know how to.
I know how to do it. That's all that counts. I don't give a shit about actually solving it.
I'm like 6 feet tall. God,
I can prove to you that this is solvable.
Oh my god, 6 foot tall pixels? Jesus Christ.
What the...
At a 4K resolution.
I don't think we all... I think we need to move this project to like Jupiter.
It's a big TV.
No, that's not that big.
I think
but it will wreak havoc on planes, though.
You'd be able to watch that TV on Earth from the moon.
Might be able to. That's a big fucking TV.
Nah, you can't see a person from the moon.
No, but a TV made with pixels the size of Darish, you could probably see.
Yeah, the entire TV just set on the moon. Everyone can watch it.
4K Darish TV?
Goddamn, think of the advertisements on that thing.
God, you know what you need the TV for?
What?
Going with the NSA and their spy satellites.
It would be 4 meters tall, 400 meters tall.
Wow, that's
400 meters tall.
That's kind of big.
Only 400 meters? I bet the Saudis are already building one.
Hey, we got extra space out here, right? Yeah, fuck it. Build a 400 meter tall TV. Who cares? Whatever. The king wanted it. He's paying us. Oh, could you imagine? That's insane.
That would mean it would be like 8 kilometers long.
Hold the guy next town over.
8 kilometers long. Can you imagine? How far away would you have to be to view that properly?
Google Earth.
Google Earth. Imagine if you hacked it and as the NSA satellites are directly overhead, you just put a fucking meat spin.
Arif, I don't think it is. It will be 8 kilometers long. 16 by 9?
Or well, of course it would be 16 by 10, dude.
Well, if you go with a 16 by 9 aspect ratio, it would be like...
A 6.
7...
6 or 7.
No, you need CinemaScope.
800 meters. It would be like...
Dude, I want a fucking... I want a TV. 700
meters wide, 400 meters tall, something like that.
I don't know, I'll take it. I want a TV that big. Because if I have a TV that big, it means I got a house that big to fit it in.
Also, we're talking about rather massive warehouse.
Yeah, a massive warehouse with a really comfortable couch in the back.
That's a hangar, actually.
All right, a hangar with a really comfortable couch in the back. Jeez, dude.
Think about going into Walmart and then selling that thing.
Here's to put it into perspective.
Imagine sitting there yelling at the planes, like, move your fucking plane out of the screen.
Look, here's a bit of perspective. That TV would be as long as 2 aircraft carriers.
Wow.
That would be how wide it is.
That's excessive.
And people would still bitch that they can't read the text on it.
Yeah.
My god, the light that thing would produce.
Oh my god. The
amount of power draw.
Actually, Mark, do you know the math to figure out how much it would cost to power that thing? How much power you would need to begin with? Never mind how much it costs. Holy shit.
No idea, man.
That's... You'd need a nuclear reactor just to power that fucking thing.
Yes.
I think you will need a lot of superconductors just the fact, just so you don't cause like severe global warming with the copper cables for it.
Not to mention trying to send out all the data to the pixels.
Well, that's not that hard. I mean, the cables, you don't have problems fitting the cables.
Well, the latency would be an issue.
Oh god, latency would be an issue at that point, wouldn't it?
Yes!
I just realized we're coming up on the speed of light here!
Well, we can actually put, well, definitely the data links all would have to be fiber, and each pixel would have to have an individual driver behind it, and a fiber connection to the main control board.
How long does it take light to cross 800 meters?
That's actually a measurable distance, I think.
It is, isn't it?
I think
so. You still won't reach the 24 FPS needed. I mean, you would even reach the 120 FPS.
But I think you can still trick a human eye to not notice that.
Yeah, I think we're fine.
So we're not coming up on that where it's going to be flickering and we're going to be fucking watching light.
What light sources do we want? I mean, we can't get LEDs that big.
Well, how about this? What about sound?
Oh, yeah, we need two
headphones.
Okay, I guess we just have, like, headphones at that point, yeah.
Oh, I kind of wanted a speaker where, like, the left side is delayed by 30 seconds and the right side's delayed by 30 seconds because it's so far away.
Well, no, you still transfer the sound via light, and then that's right, the sound would actually... What would the viewing distance be for this massive TV to see the whole TV first? Then we can figure out through the speed of sound how delayed the sound's going to be from the TV.
I think you would need to measure the viewing distance in miles.
No, it's not miles.
Can't be miles.
But I mean, what's the normal viewing distance for a screen? I'm sitting as far from my screen as it is wide. Mm-hmm. About
half a mile. A third of a mile, more or less.
A mile away. How long would it take sound to travel a third of a mile?
So you would say that your TV has Comcast 2 gigabit internet, but you don't.
About 2 seconds.
Yeah.
That would also cost latency.
So what we're saying is we're building a TV and a viewing station bigger than Area 51.
Basically.
We're planning out a TV where we start to consider speed of sound as a factor.
Yeah.
To be honest, I still don't know how we're going to do so much. I would suggest you take those light bulbs they have in lighthouses for each pixel.
That might work. And put like a red filter over them or something for each pixel.
So you mean three per pixel?
Well, yeah.
Sure.
No. You know what, guys?
And don't forget yellow. We need yellow too.
Yes, I was about to say we need to contact Sharp on this. We need to patent. We need to license the yellow pixel.
But that is a proper color scheme that includes yellow.
Yeah. Why are we doing this? Are we trying to eliminate epileptics from the world?
the only thing you show on is Pokemon.
By the way...
I said no. I said epileptics, not autistics.
Guys, here's the thing. We would also have to make a no-go zone, which is like...
Oh, we need a 60... no-fly zone, that's right.
Yes,
shit.
No, actually a no-anything zone, because I'm guessing about the amount of energy... that this will take, being like 60 meters away from this will probably give you a nasty sunburn within a few seconds of exposure.
At least it wouldn't be weeds.
How much power does a lighthouse draw?
One of those light bulbs? Like 20 kilovolts? Kilowatts of power? And they're actually...
Alright, 1,000 watts.
Mark, they're actually...
We have 8.8 million of these. So, we have 8.8 million kilowatts.
Mark, those things are actually xenon discharge lamps. They're pretty much a lightning arc enclosed in a glass bulb.
So, hold on. Did I hear that right? This is going to take 8.8 million kilowatts of power?
8,800
megawatts. 8.8 gigawatts, yes.
Yeah.
8.8 gigawatts of power, huh?
If you're powering with lighthouses, yes.
What's the output of a nuclear reactor?
This would be enough. One nuclear reactor would be enough.
Yeah, it would work.
One nuclear reactor. So we're going to have to build this on a major river somewhere.
Yes.
That's just not...
Guys, a typical nuclear reactor that you have like in the States,
uh-huh,
is only an output of 3 megawatts.
Well, no, we're 3, talking like megawatts.
3 gigawatts.
Well, how about Indian Point? How about Indian Point? How much does that put out, Darius? We find that out. Because Indian Point powers New York City.
And then it's going to blow up New York City.
2,000 megawatts.
So we need a nuclear reactor that can power more than New York City.
We need a nuclear reactor that can power...
Overestimate the light bulb requirement. Let's go down to 200 watts per pixel.
So what you're saying is this TV draws more power than the DeLorean time machine.
This TV draws more power than New York fucking city.
But let me sort this by output.
Looking into 8.8 million lighthouses that they turn on?
Okay.
That'd be great.
The closest thing we can get in the state is the one that powers pretty much a decent chunk of Canada, the Bruce Nuclear Generator System.
You know,
and
I
that's
just...
6,233 megawatts.
Okay. So we need to build a nuclear reactor like that. That'll be enough. So then the question I have for you, Mark, is,
how much?
No, if we turn this thing on and this actually works, is the power of the light going to vaporize anything in front of it?
Yes.
No, but it's going to be very warm.
Mm.
Very, very warm.
The moment we start this, expect no winter in the general vicinity.
We said we are curving it. Wouldn't that be like a lens focusing?
Oh god. So if you would be too close to it, you will probably end up
Maybe not curve it then. Yeah, that's probably a bad idea with the curving. You should not do that.
Yeah. I just want to say I'm behind this because fuck winter in this area.
You turn the TV on and all the grass lights on fire.
Well, here's the question. How do we cool it then? Because obviously it's going to need to expel heat. How do we get that heat away from...
Well, lighthouses get cooled somehow.
Well, yeah, but we're not building a lighthouse. We're building a flat panel display made of lighthouses.
Liquid nitrogen.
Duh, it's going to be a little too much. Can we do this in Antarctica? Can we do that? Because they constantly have like melting ice, so we can use that cold
water.
No,
you can't. Why not? You can't do this in Antarctica because after that there's no Antarctica.
Oh, okay.
We'll probably add them. And the second thing of all, the second thing is that we would need to build two. For example, we can use two Palo Verde nuclear generator stations. That thing is a nuclear power plant that powers the whole south of Arizona. We need two of these.
Two of those. All right. Well, I'm thinking. Boy, you know, I'm thinking this is not going to be cheap. That's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking this is not going to be cheap. I think this is going to cost quite a bit of money. This is going to be expensive.
Yeah,
Kickstarter.
Well, actually, we need one pixel less because there's just going to be one pixel, as you requested.
I will probably immediately evaporate.
He will be the one dead pixel.
Oh god, could you imagine if we had to have a refund policy if we had dead pixels on this thing? Holy shit.
There's no refund policy.
Well, the thing is, it's so big, you can actually repair it.
Oh yeah, you can actually take out the pixel. Oh, you know what, guys? We have, like, enough info on this. Let's make a nice graphic render and make a Kickstarter for it.
We could do a Kickstarter for it.
What
we could do is we could do a Kickstarter, maybe not for this, but for, like, you know, an exorbitantly large TV type of thing, and be like, hey, we want to build this, and it'll be great for you really rich folks out there. Ha ha ha.
And then after two years, we say, like, oh, fuck, we failed because we spent $50 million on offices and rental space.
Yeah, we spent half of your money on a shitty game show. Sorry, we forgot about that.
Spent your money on food.
Instead of this 800-meter-tall TV, we only made a 10-meter-tall TV. Here you go.
Yes. And please ignore the fact that Darish has a new Mercedes.
Nice Ambilight. Always stand on Ambilight.
Oh god, if we would install Ambilight on this TV, the guys behind the TV would... Oh god.
Oh dear lord.
Use Ambilight not on the wall behind the TV, but on the mountain.
Not on the mountain, Mark. I think the guys... Like, let's say we build this in the States, the guys on the state behind the TV will not know what night is. They will have all the colors in the sky all the time.
Do you think we'd outshine the Aurora Borealis at that point?
Probably.
When we need 8 million 8 gigawatts of power, I'm quite sure.
The only thing I know is no ships would ever crash ever again.
You know, at this point, I'd be tempted just to shine that fucker into space and see if anyone sees it.
Oh, you will.
Look at our TV, motherfucker! So.
Well, no, the observation will be like, why the fuck is there a second sun?
What the hell is this?
That's not going to be that bad.
Oh, could you, if you pointed at the moon, could you see it from the moon?
No, still too small. You know what?
No, not too small.
Still too small.
No, no, not, not saying too small. I'm saying definitely. The light.
You would see the light.
Yeah, okay.
You will see the bright dot.
There was an one of the XKCD was on that. The one, the science ones he does, was on how much light you would need to make what the sun bright.
You need to send this to this guy. Yeah, calculate.
What? We want to build this.
We'd like to build this.
How much power do you need to power a TV that has a pixel as big as a person, powered by lighthouses?
6 foot by 6 foot pixel. How much? That 6 foot by 6 foot 4K television. How much? How much would you powered by like lighthouse lights or some shit? How much power would you? How much power would you draw from that?
But you need to watch it.
Oh, if you. Oh, I found the XKCD episode. Herb was talking. If you would want to illuminate the moon, you would need 50 trillion megawatt lasers.
No, that's to illuminate the moon. But like, how much would it be to see the bright dot from the moon?
You see New York from the moon, so it's not that much.
You would definitely see the TV. Honestly, you'd probably be able to play Atari from the moon on this TV.
You might be able to, right? You might be able to play Atari.
That lag, no. Too much input lag.
Yeah, that's a little bit of lag. I'm listening to this and wondering, how would you have a remote control that could control the TV?
Laser remote control.
No, it's got to be like a fiber remote or laser or something like that.
Instead
it's
of
no way.
Infrared, you would have to use
well,
laser.
Well, you wouldn't be able to. The infrared would be drowned out by the IR from the TV.
Yeah. That's why you need laser.
How powerful of an IR remote would you... Well, that's another thing to ask. How powerful of an IR remote would you need?
What's even the biggest industrial strength IR light bulb I can get?
Oh, God. That's... what would the IR output of that TV be at that point? How would your IR receiver even detect your remote from an eighth of a mile away?
Hey guys, I think we've gone from innocent curiosity to full-on hardware development.
Starting Kickstarter now.
We've gone. I think we've gone to depths that even NASA's like, nah, it's all right. Cool guys.
NASA's like, it's cool guys. The Super Bowl is not that important for the people of the ISS. Because you would see that thing from the ISS.
Easily. You could actually see what's on it from the ISS.
You can just imagine every half an hour, whatever the cycle time is for that thing, every half an hour they all look out of the side of the window to see the current score.
No, Mark. Here's the thing. They would go like, we need to change it to geostationary so we can watch this.
That's way higher up, though.
What if you put this in orbit? Could you get like global advertising in the sky?
Don't give Facebook ideas.
But again, then you wouldn't you need to curve it then?
But
and wouldn't you make a nuclear?
You would, wouldn't you?
but the thing is, then you're making a nuclear fucking powered lens.
But according to some conspiracy theories, the sky is already a massive projection screen. So.
Oh my god, that would be fucking funny. you would have to launch two nuclear fucking reactors into space, and like fucking dock it with this huge goddamn TV. How much more expensive can we make this ridiculous project of ours?
Okay. I do have to say that the sky cannot possibly be a huge projection screen because I've not seen one fucking ad on it.
How can we make this even more ridiculous? Let's make it 8K future-proof.
16K.
Oh my god. 16K. A 16K TV with 6x6 foot fucking pixels.
16K the dream.
Now we're talking, because that whole...
Now I think we do need to get in touch with the XKCD guy and ask him this. Ask him just this series of questions, like, how much power would this take? How many nuclear reactors would I need? How far away would I have to sit to fucking discern an image? And how would I get it into space to have it float around the Earth to offer advertising to the masses?
And how do I not die from radioactivity?
Imagine what the fuck would happen to all the electronics? What's the EMI output on this?
Oh God, what's the E? It's supposed to take interference too. What's the E? What's
oof. This would probably kill like all electronics in the state this would be installed in. Cell phone reception? What's that? Forget it.
Cell phone? Fuck you, man. You'd be lucky to not be cooked alive by the IR output of this fucking thing. Jesus Christ. Why did
my
you
God,
build
I mean,
this?
how do you actually dim lighthouse things? You mean have to put something in front of them, right?
Yeah, you dim it by like putting something in front of it, yeah.
Imagine like a 6 foot...
Or, well, there are electric ones that you can dim with electricity.
Usually, but on that power level?
Usually... We'll have a... No, usually the lighthouses have a xenon discharge light bulb, and to dim it, you put a water-cooled iron plate in front of it.
Yep, that's actually what we have to do. So we have to have an iron plate in front of it that's 3 foot by 3 foot, and it needs to be water-cooled, which is fine, I guess.
Yeah.
And, well, that thing needs to snap in front of that. Well, how many hertz do we need? Need at least 60,
it's
right?
It's got to be at least 60, hopefully 120, but we can go 60. All right,
so this thing has to like move in front of the thing in 240 times a second, which is quick for a 3 foot thing.
It's a little fast, yeah.
So
can we go back on the water cooling? We would make a boiling lake.
Keep the water boiling.
I, Karif, I have the answer. You can sell it as a hot tub spell.
Dude, it would be boiling water.
Yes.
No, it's not water cooled, it's waterfall cooled.
Well, now, hang on. We want to get into that. Can we... God, how much water would it require?
We have plenty of water.
Oh, well, we can... let me ask you this, though. How long does it take to service this thing? Because... No human being is going to be able to walk into there. It's a heat death trap. You're going to melt. I mean, you'd have to turn the whole fucking thing off, wait for it to cool to an acceptable level, and then fix the thing and then turn it on. How long does it take for this thing to heat up?
How long does it take for a lighthouse to heat up?
A couple of hours.
All right, yeah, sure.
A couple of hours.
Mm-hmm. You got your answer.
Oh, I got my answer, great. I can't even imagine. There are a lot of technical hurdles with this thing.
Yes, but the thing, what's scary, we actually figured most of them out.
This is a scary thing to listen to. I apologize to the scientists in the audience.
Actually, I have an idea. We can make a water desolidifying plant. Have so much water cooking.
Yeah, we could turn that into a profit. We could have a water desalinization.
Yeah, but you need to... Pay attention California so that the steam actually gets out on the back of the thing. You don't want it disrupting the...
Actually, now that I think about it, if we had just steam coming off of this TV, would we create our own weather systems?
Yes. Probably.
The weather would be fog.
Oh, holy shit, it would consume so much water doing it that way.
Oh, man.
Also, but then again, if we would trap that steam and use it in a turbine...
Use it in a turbine to power things, yeah. That'd be good.
Power the TV.
How that doesn't work.
Why?
Damn it.
Actually, it would work. I mean, it would make it slightly more efficient, wouldn't it?
It would at least
help. It
would
make it more efficient, yes.
I'm not saying it would power itself. I'm just saying it would be slightly more efficient.
Well, maybe at one point we can turn off the second nuclear reactor.
Turn it on the weekends.
Oh, God. Have a battery bank back there just to catch up with the demand.
If the TV is warm enough, you can turn off the secondary nuclear reactor.
When it finally warms up, you can disable the nuclear reactor site B.
I love that line.
The better the manual to start it. Start up reactor block A. Start up reactor block B.
Wait 7 hours. Now you can turn off reactor block B because it's warm enough.
And that's why we bought a hybrid.
Oh my God. Could you imagine? And its whole purpose is just float around the earth advertising Facebook. God, how big of an area of free space would we need for this? This is fucking ridiculous.
The thing is, you would have to compartmentalize certain things, so a lot of space. You just can't have the... the reactor next to the TV because
that's too much heat. That was way too much heat.
Well, what would happen if one of these reactors hit critical max and exploded?
How high would it need to be? I mean, you can see a TV perfectly fine at about distance of about 10 times its width, so it can be like 8 kilometers high, so 5 miles high.
So, well, here's the thing. If we would
it would be kind of small at that point.
If we curve it, that would make it into a lens. So that will pretty much, if we curve it at the right angle, we'll just have this death beam like flying over the earth and leaving a scar.
I'm gonna kill you with ads.
Oh my god.
Won the last Super Bowl ad, funny? Well, eat this.
Yeah, turn the screen completely white so it, suddenly you get hit by like 8 gigawatts of energy.
If I made a TV made out of 6 foot by 6 foot pixels, what would happen, Mr. Monroe? You'd die.
You'd fry the universe.
You'd fry half the universe. Oh man, that's a lot of energy. That's a lot of fucking energy.
For argument's sake, let's assume that we are not really going to die from that. And that we have the by the way, how fast we would run out of resources building that thing?
The moment we launched on Kickstarter, we would be out of resources to build it.
We should launch it on Kickstarter. I can use the extra money.
I would like to see the news article. The news article with this, the TV explodes, everybody died.
Have this thing fly over the Super Bowl every year.
The massive Jumbotron explodes at Super Bowl. 2.5 million people die.
Nuclear fallout everywhere.
We have two warning, we have two nuclear reactors in free fall. We don't know where they're going to land. Kiss your ass goodbye, guys.
Conservative investment, everybody.
Yes, we have two reactors re-entering the atmosphere, guys.
Wouldn't that work like a dirty bomb, then?
That's pretty much what it would be. It would be a massive dirty bomb.
But if anybody says this is kind of stupid and will break everything, you say, no, global warming isn't real.
Global warming's not real. Relax. If anything, this will be enough of an impact to create global cooling, so watch out.
Nuclear winter.
There you go, see?